It was during my first 2 weeks when I was there. There was a lot of work to do in terms of setting up the facilities and the staffing. I was very overworked, very busy, very stressed out. I just didn't take any time really to interact with the patients or to really even rest. But there was three patients that were inside the isolation for those first 2 weeks. And there were three boys. I think their names were Dorbor, Momo, and Alfred. And every time I would walk by the area where they were in isolation, they were in the confirmed area, the confirmed cases, they would yell to me, "Hello, Eric, hey, Eric." They would always try to start a conversation. I quickly tried to have a conversation, but I was quite busy. "I'm sorry, guys, I have to go run back to work." And as I said, it was really a stressful period. I was constantly questioning why I was there in that period, because, you know, my first time working with Ebola, I was questioning, why am I putting myself at risk like this? Why am I overworking myself this way? And then I remember one day, I was walking past the house where we keep our, where all of the discharge patients would stay. Usually they'd be discharged in the afternoon, then they would go home and the next morning. And I walked by there and there were those three boys. They were just sitting outside hanging out. I'm like, I was so shocked. I thought, like, hey, you guys are on the wrong side of the fence. What are you guys doing here? It really was a turning point for me in the mission, because it made me realize why I was putting myself through so much stress, why I was working so hard, why I was taking the bit of risk that it was taking by working in Ebola contact, when you see the patients that were inside the fence and then one day they're outside the fence. It's amazing. I'm going back because, again, I feel like it's something that I can really provide some value to, and working with MSF, we can provide a lot of value. I gained a lot of experience working in Ebola the first time with MSF, and the outbreak is still ongoing, and I think it's my responsibility with the experience I have to continue on with MSF and inside of this this epidemic until we see the end of it.